and the green jersey arrives at the front. It's Mike Turnerson who has done the job for Binyam Gourmet, but he is a long way forward. They now go across the right of the peloton to slot alongside Astana and the other big sprinters. Turnerson cannot do this on his own. Binyam Gourmet has got to find other teams to work off.
Oh, big moment there for the rider from Bahrain Victorious that looked like Mohoric there got caught on the wrong side of the wheel.
Jaco Alula on the left coming through in orange for their sprinter, Dylan Groenewegen.
Well, you can see each of these teams fighting their way up on the left and switching across to the right, but it's still Visma Lisa bike holding that right-hand gutter.
And Cavendish has been filtered back. He takes a look through. He goes the go-go gadget neck to see Ford, looking for a safe stretch of road.
Well, Team Astana need to find a way out of this hole soon because every time a wave of riders come past on the left, they're getting pushed further back on the right.
In 800 metres, there is a left-hand turn, then sweeps around to the right, underneath the kite, one roundabout, and then they'll see the finish line.
Big push up the right-hand side of the road now for Team Astana. Cavendish grasping for position.
They've made the most of that brief moment. As the road opened up, it's Ballerini who brings them to the front. This is Dorian Gourdon at the head of the race. The big Frenchman doing the job for Sam Bennett. Mikhail Morkow, he's got himself in amongst the riders from Astana. That's the guy they need.
Abra Hansen now on the front of the peloton in the polka dot jersey, looking over his shoulder. Where is Alexander Kristoff?
We know Alexander Kristoff was good yesterday. He was third, and he's got a long lead-out train. They're the riders in the red and orange colours from Uno X Mobility.
Gourdon still leading the peloton through that left-hand bend. Now they'll come up to 3 kilometres to go.
Me and my shadow, Tadej Pogačar and Jonas Vingegaard side by side. Staying safe, staying out of trouble. Uno X, they dominate the left-hand side of the road. It's Astana dominating the right.
Gourdon pulling off to the right there. Look like Ballerini may be sprinting his way through.
And Wout van Aert not interested. He's all the way down the back. Lutsenko swings off. He gets out of the way. It's still Abra Hansen in the polka dots. The grey colours. It is Alpecin de Koenig charging for the front.
Matej Mohoric in a good position there. He has Phil Bauhaus on his wheel for Bahrain Victorious, sitting about second position back.
There is no breathing space. A right-hand turn to come. There's Mads Pedersen. He's fought his way into contention. He's on the wheel of Jasper Stuyven. Pedersen has already been the most combative just from making the start line after yesterday's horrific crash.
The road about to swing round to the right after they go under this underpass. And then there's that pinch point to the left with 1,700 metres to go.
The national champion of Belgium, Arnaud Delis, the black, the yellow and the red. The debutant is in contention. He's had a top three finish already. Shoulder rubbing at the front. Matthew van der Poel has got himself right where he needs to be to lead out Jasper Philipsen.
Matthew van der Poel still has one rider left in front of him. Well placed there. Fighting him for the wheel of Wout van Aert.
And the rider that sits behind Philipsen is Binyam Gourmet. 1,600 metres, 1 mile in the old money, but it's new superstars trying to upset the experience of Cavendish. Can Binyam Gourmet get it done again today, or will it be the young Belgium Arnaud Delis?
Huge effort here for Uno X Mobility, still holding the front position. Next to take over was Warren's Gold.
Charging through in the orange, Jaco Alula looking for Groenewegen. Almer Reindeers is the rider for Jaco Alula. He's got Luca Mezgets behind him, and then he's got Groenewegen, followed then by Delis. 1 kilometre remaining.
That's Magnus Cort Nelson still on the front there for Uno X. He's coming up to this important roundabout in around 200 metres time. Will he get through?
And caught back, Philipsen, Delis, and also Binyam Gourmet. They've got a lot of work to do. They are in heavy traffic. Alexander Kristoff, he's in third position. That's a sweet position to be.
Binyam Gourmet also well placed through that right-hand bend. The green jersey right up there.
The Alpecin de Koenig train is coming. It's charging on the rights. Matthew van der Poel, the world champion, is about to open up the afterburners. And van Aert has got himself in the mix. Van Aert it is who sits in third position. He's looking to challenge. Delis is also opening up. Philipsen, van Aert, a rubbing shoulders. Dalia is in contention. Groenewegen with some hope. It'll be tied on the line. We await for confirmation. They don't know, nor do we. We hold our breath. Groenewegen gets the win. Philipsen in second. Binim Gumay in third. Jacob Olula, they took a punt on Dylan Groenewegen a few years ago. His dad is there to enjoy it. Take us through it.
Matthew Vanderpool leading out here, really open upping his sprint early. Philipsen hard on his wheel, but he left his acceleration a moment too late. Shoulder to shoulder with Wout van Aert on the right, but it was Groenewegen who powered up the left-hand side of the road. From the overhead now, maybe Groenewegen started to fade, through for the line, strong enough to take the win. Another solid sprint by Binim Gumay up the middle of the road.
And the long look across to his right for Groenewegen, over to the left from Philipsen. Did you get it? I'm not sure. How about you?